Hello, welcome to SS Unitech Social Design, and this is continuation of SSIS tutorial. So today we gonna discuss about checkpoints. So what is checkpoint and how we can use it in our package? So let's start with checkpoints. So it is used when package fails. So basically it is used to restart the package from the point of failure instead of rerunning whole the package, and it will start from the point of failure. And it is very useful while we are going to deal with large data, like we are going to import and export images. Assume you have 100 tasks in a package and 99 tasks have been completed with success and our last task would be failed. If we are not going to configure checkpoints in our package, then after correcting the error, once we run our package, then whole package will rerun and all the tasks will be rerun. If we are going to configure checkpoints in our package, then our last task will be executed and 99 tasks which have been executed with success will not going to execute again. So how we can configure? Go to on SSDT, and here I would like to add one more package. Then I wish to rename this package with checkpoints. After that, here I wish to add couple of execute SQL task. So I gonna use 3 execute SQL task. Then I want to configure our first. Here I need to create a connection with any database. So click on OK. Here I gonna select 100. That is fine. Now click on OK. Connect with our second execute SQL task. Here make a connection. Here I wanna create a custom error. So 100 divided by 0, so it will reflect an error. Now click on OK. In our third execute SQL task, I wanna make connection. Then I wanna select 1. So once our package will be executed, then our second execute SQL task will be failed. So our package will be failed at this point. So I wanna use checkpoints. So go to on properties of the package, and here as you can see, here we have checkpoint options. So first is file name. So here we need to select a file name. I gonna create a file at the runtime with the name of checkpoint.xml. Now click on open. Once our package will be failed, then package information will be stored on this file. In our checkpoint uses, I gonna use if exist. In our save checkpoints, select with true. Now we have done. Now we can cancel this. And at the task level, we need to set a property which is fail package on failure. We need to select with true. In our second execute SQL task, again we need to select true. In our last, again we need to select with true. Now we can close it. Now we can save it. Now I gonna execute this package. So our first task will be executed successfully, and in our second task will be failed. So click on start. So as we can see, first task executed successfully. So go to on the folder. So here as we can see, we are having checkpoints.xml file. Now we can edit in notepad++. So this is our checkpoint file. So it has the information of our package. Now go to on SSDT, stop this package. So once again we will execute our package, then our first task will not going to execute one more time because it has been executed successfully. So our package will be executed at our second execute SQL task. So let's remove the error, and I wanna use select 5. Now click on OK. So our package will be executed and it will start from second execute SQL task. Now click on start. So as we can see, our first execute SQL task is not executed. Our last two execute SQL tasks have been executed. So once package executed successfully, then checkpoint file will be deleted. So as we can see, we are not having file over here. Now stop this package. I hope you have understand how we can use the checkpoints in our package. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you like this video, please subscribe our channel to get many more videos. Don't forget to press the bell icon to get the notification of our newly uploaded videos. Thank you so much.